there, if they are not taken care, they will resort into some other thing and totally lose the embrace of the Vedic system. That's why in order to bring them, see, whenever you go to somebody, even if a thief is there, if he wants to rob the chain of the child, he will first give what the child needs, a chocolate. Then he will take what he wants. Even in the spiritual observation method, these people, those who are cruel in nature, they are just in the pretext of a sacrifice, in the pretext of an offer, they are being linked with the system. Then properly, within the birth or gradually, over various births, those people, they are promoted towards sattvika guna, by which they will realize that it is a mistake. If this divine pretextual prescription is not there, then unlimited and non-systematic way of consumption or as well as hunting of animals would have been there. So in order to limit and to organize a habit, if you ask a person to immediately leave everything, he will ask for a second way. He will not come to you. So there is a pretextual design for that one. By means of rituals, there is a possibility for mitigation by exercising arduous exercises. Number two, the third thing is very simple. It is not administered for sophisticated spiritual authorities. In all other grown religions and civilized religions, at the time of maturity, they did not administer that. There is also one fourth rule that Vedas, they don't have animal sacrifice at all. There is one word known as Alambhana. If you say Ashwamedha is killing a horse, then Pitrumedha, you have to kill your father in the ritual. So there are a lot of other linguistic as well as etymological derivations and expressions given in the research books, whereby they say that all the verbal base or root that has been interpreted to kill or to hunt or to destroy, everything is just meant for to touch. To touch. Alambana means Guru Hu Sishyamalabhate, means Guru touches the Sishya. There are a lot of words. Pashumalabhate, Agneshomike, Shweta Pashumalabheta, Vayu, Vaikshepishta, Devata. So this is the Veda. Vayu is a very great Devata. Immediately he can be propitiated. So you have to give a white goat for that. So that Alabheta, here it means kill. There it means Guru Sishya, not kill, just to touch. So they have interpreted that. So there are four theories. One is a prohibition theory for the advanced people or the broad-minded people who should be the real goal makers and the exemplary models of the society. It is prohibited. Number two, to minimize it has been ritualized, to divert and systematize it so that it can be regulated and slowly extirpated from the society. It has been made in the pretext of village gods or sacrifice. Number fourth, in intellectual management, this has been clearly interpreted that it has been misinterpreted by people instead of touching for killing. These are all the explanations.
Yes.
Yes.
The sacrifice which is which in Sanskrit is called Yajna. In the Treta Yuga, the Yajna system and understanding deteriorated easily. And Dravya Yajna was composed, the substitute, which was merely symbolic. Therefore, my friend's problem is that whether Himsa is involved. Actually, the animal is killed means the Pashu, Pashu Murti is killed. Now this symbolic meaning is lost, which was in the Vedas. And the degeneration took place, and the symbolic yajna, which became a ritual, which is being carried forward to this day. Even Vajpayee's election, they carry a yajna, which I fail to understand.
Yes, that is nice. There are Havir Yajna, Dravya Yajna, Pashu Yajna and Soma Yajna, in which juice is offered, meat is offered, a living being is offered, and these things are very common. And one thing I want to say, the Shastras even say that there is one wonderful greatness of our Shastras. That's what I told you in the seminar on monotheism. Western religions are also monotheistic, we are also monotheistic. But they are radically monotheistic and we are rationally monotheistic. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, O Arjuna, I have created lot of deities and I have created the hierarchy of worship. And each and everybody, as per their taste, they worship their god, like food taste and language taste and their own cultural taste, they worship their own deities. Gradually, they are accustomed with a bondage with the deity and approach the Paramatman, the Supreme Being, myself. So where is that god who says that he has created all systems and each and everybody should gradually develop and he is the institute of faith in all religions and their respective worship? Where is that god? And where is this god who is saying that everybody should be destroyed? So that is radical monotheism, it is rational monotheism. Likewise in Vedas, one more quality is, if a person, for example, there is Shena Yajna. What is it? Shena Yajna. Hirana Yajna is organized for destructing an enemy, killing an enemy. If the Vedas will not give a shelter for a person's desire to kill his enemy, immediately he will take some other measures to kill. Anyone he is going to kill, he cannot be prevented. And he will be disturbed a lot. So the Vedas administer Hirana Yajna, and after the completion of Hirana Yajna, in that Nibandha, in that explanation, it says that anybody killing the enemy will get into a sin. For extinguishing of the sin, he has to go for Tirtha Yatra, he has to dip in various other bathing exercises and various other things. So the person realizes that it is sin. So whenever a person's immediate taste towards an act is not preventable by means of a strong admonishment or order, injunction, that order is immediately implemented by the Vedas, and gradually the person's mental transformation is also guaranteed by the Vedas. So if somebody is taking some sort of flesh or meat in the pretext of, it is not for sattvika people, it is only for the tamasic people, even if they take that, if it is not restricted, they will take more. That's why we used to say, apa dharma, yuga dharma, vishishta dharma, adhikari dharma. In this Kali Yuga, all these things are prevented. All these animal sacrifices, even if you accept that they have been exercised, they have been prevented in Kali Yuga. Because Kali Yuga, they know that apart from rituals, each and everybody is making sacrifice. There is bombings, everything is a sacrifice. Now we have come to human sacrifice, not even animal sacrifice. So, if Veda says something, it is to come in your way, to bring us to our way, that is their way. So, the Vedas are so kind enough to come in your way, gradually promote and organize your mental transformation, so that you can be very slowly and steadily incorporated into the Vedic design of non-violence. If you initially implement non-violence, if somebody says in Veda that you come here, I'll give you wealth, I'll destroy your enemy, I'll give you some sort of benefit like Svarga, if you say that, they will come to these things. If you really enumerate by means of saying ethical injunction, nobody will come there. Even those who should not be deprived of the Vedic benefits, in order to have a pretextual incorporation of their invitation to get their immediate benefits, they are invited as if they are going to get the immediate benefits. Slowly they are injected with a transformation power by which they are also culminated towards a spiritual framework.